Hallelujah. Greetings once again in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We are glad to be before you once again with our series of Psalms. And today we have Psalm 20 for our meditation. So you can open your Bible to Psalm 20 and we could see the beautiful prayer of King David. David's beautiful prayer. When I was reading and meditating on this word, I felt like David was praying for somebody. He says, may the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. May the Lord answer you. May the Lord, the God of Jacob, defend you. May he send you help from the sanctuary and strengthen you out of Zion. May he remember all your offerings and accept your burnt offering. To me, it seems that David is praying for somebody, that God will answer that person. In whatever problem he is. Today we have no answers in this world. No one can answer our prayers. There are some problems that we come across. Even ministers cannot help us. Even kings cannot help us. Especially time of sickness. Even doctors fail. We are ready even to spend anything, but doctors fail. So in time of trouble, who can we turn to? So David's prayer is that may the Lord help you in the day of your trouble. May the name of the God of Jacob defend you. Why does he take the name of Jacob? Jacob was a person who faced so much problems in his life. His own brother wanted to kill him. His own father loved his elder brother more than him. And the father had blessing reserved only for his brother, not for him. And Jacob, we know that he cheated and he took the blessing from his father. And because of that, Esau, his brother, wanted to kill Jacob. And then Jacob had to run for his life. He had to leave his home, leave his mother and father, leave his family, and had to run away. For maybe about 22 years, he had to be outside. And when he was so many years outside, he faced so many problems, even in his father-in-law's house. So therefore, David is using that term. He says, may the God of Jacob defend you. We need defense. We need somebody to defend us, like how God defended Jacob. Even though he was wrong, even though he cheated, he was a deceiver, but still God protected him. And he says, Esau I have hated, Jacob I have loved. How could we understand this phrase of God, this point of God? He loves one and he hates another. Who can question God? And that God of Jacob who favored Jacob, David is saying, that God who favored Jacob may favor you also, may protect you. And then he says, may he send you help from his sanctuary and strengthen you out of Zion. May he remember all your offerings and accept your burnt offering. Whatever offerings we bring to the Lord, now it is no more burnt offerings, there's no more goats and sheep and fowls. Today, the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross paid everything for us. We do not have to take any more sacrifice and go to the house of God. We do not have to burn candles. We do not have to do anything in the house of God. We just have to go as we are. Because in the sanctuary, God is there present to bless us as his children because of what Jesus did on the cross. And therefore it says here, may the Lord strengthen you from Zion. May he send you help from his sanctuary. May he remember all your offering and accept your burnt sacrifice. May he accept your burnt sacrifice. Whatever prayer we go, whatever problem we take and go before the Lord, many times our relationship is not right with God, not right with our brother. Jesus says when you bring your sacrifice and come to the altar, and when you remember that your brother has something against you, he says leave your offering at the altar, go and reconcile with your brother, then come back and offer your sacrifice. What does Jesus mean? Relationship is more than offering. Relationship is more than giving money or giving something. Relationship, love, relationship with God and the relationship with man should be right for God to accept us. That is why it says in one place, I call it the 420 love. In 1 John chapter 4 verse 20 it says, I call it the 420 love. If you cannot love your brother who you can see, how could you love God whom you cannot see? That is true. It's called 420 love. Yeah, I love God, but you can't see God. How could you love somebody you can't see? Your brother you can see, but you don't love him. So therefore, when we come to God, let our relationship be right with one another, right with God also. Then God accepts our sacrifice and he blesses us. What else David is praying over here? May he grant you according to your heart's desire and fulfill all your purpose. How many of you know that only God can fulfill your purposes and give you the desires of your heart? That is why David says, when you delight yourself in the Lord, he will give you the desires of your heart. Only the desires of the heart, only God knows, and only God can fulfill, not man. It is not the things of the earth, it's not riches. It is nothing that we think is blessing. Blessing is when God is with you. Hallelujah. Therefore, let us see how God blesses. We will rejoice in your salvation, and in the name of our God, we will set up our banners. May the Lord fulfill all your petition. May the Lord fulfill all your desires, means answer all your prayers. There are many prayers that we put up to God, whether he is answering it or not. James said he does not answer because we ask amiss. We don't ask in the correct way. And therefore God cannot answer that prayer because it is not asked in the right way. So therefore let us put our relationship right with God, and then he will answer our prayer also. David said something very beautiful in the 7th verse. He says, some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. They have bowed down and fallen, but we have risen and stand upright. Some trust in chariots. What are you trusting in, my friend? Who are you trusting in? You may have a minister friend. You may have a plenty of wealth. You may have a great name. You may have big certificates. You may have high qualification. What are you trusting on today? You know, all these things go. All these things go. But if you put your trust in God, he will fulfill the desires of your heart. He is the one that is able to keep you. David, through experience, is talking here. Even there were kings that were mightier than him, stronger than him, who were able to come with huge armies and so many chariots and horses against him. Those kings were trusting on their army and the chariots and the horses. But David trusted in the Lord, and he won every battle. Every battle David won because his trust was in the Lord. Nowhere we find in anywhere in the Bible that David lost some battle. David always won because his trust was in the Lord. You remember the story when Goliath came against David? When Goliath came, David says, you come against me with shield and buckler and helmet and armor and lance and sword, but I come against you in the name of the Lord God of Israel, whom you have challenged. Hallelujah. And we know with one stone, Goliath was killed. Hallelujah. That is what happened. Those that trust in their armor, in their own strength. Goliath was plus 9 feet plus. 9 feet plus. And David was a little boy, maybe 5 feet something. Almost double his height. A man of war. A man who has seen many dead. A man has killed many people. That type of person came against David. But because David put his trust in the Lord, he was able to overcome Goliath. You want to overcome your Goliath? You want to overcome the giant that is in your life? Put your trust in the Lord. David did that. He says, I come against you in the name of God of Israel. Hallelujah. No other God. I'm not telling you to put your trust in any other God. No other God can help you but the God of Israel. And his name is Jesus. Hallelujah. When you put your trust in him, your Goliath will fall. He has to fall. Hallelujah. You want to overcome your Goliath? The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus is above every other name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. David, through experience, has said this. Because when he was feeding his father's sheep, a lion came to take away one of his lambs. He went after the lion, he says. And he took the lamb out of the lion's mouth and he killed the lion. 15, 16-year-old boy I'm talking about, not a Goliath, not a warrior like Goliath. I'm talking about a 15, 16-year-old boy, took the lamb out of the lion's mouth and killed a lion, a real lion, not a zoo lion, a real lion. Then also a bear came That bear also, when it attacked the flock, David killed the bear also. So his confidence is the God that saved him from the lion, the God that saved him from the bear, will save him also from Goliath. And he won. So the God that has protected you and called you, he can protect you from every kind of disease, every kind of germs, every kind of virus. Don't be afraid of coronavirus today. If your trust is in the Lord, even coronavirus will be defeated by you. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless the reading of His word today. We had this nice study, and I believe that you are blessed also. May God keep you in the blessing of the Lord, and may your eyes be fixed upon the God of Israel, who will always give you the victory in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.